Okay, now we're going to create the nose of the plane. For this, we're going to select the faces of the front and then extrude them. Now we're doing this because we're going to use the bevel tool to create the round nose. So for this, we have to select the edge loop. And then we're going to say bevel edge. Then we're going to increase the fraction to 1 and increase the segments. So something like 4. And then we can see we have a very nice rounded nose. So now we can take care of the engine. So for this, we're going to select the front faces and create a small engine compartment where we're then going to put in the cooling fans. Now we can quickly deselect or reduce the selection by using the smaller than key on the keyboard, and then we get this inner selection, and now we can make this a little smaller and extrude this out, and that's going to be the place where we're going to add the propeller. Now we're going to, so for me right now, this is a little too round. So I'm going to use the Insert Edge Loop tool to cage the edge to give it a much sharper edge than before. So now you see here, now we have a much sharper edge. And the same thing we repeat on the back side and here. For the propeller. Okay, so now this is much more defined. Okay, then we are going to create a cube. This is going to be one of our cooling fans, and we're just going to position it here in the middle of our engine block, and we're going to use the vertex points. Oops. There we go, the vertex points, and move them over here, and these will move over there. Yeah, so I'm not really concerned that they're cutting into this geometry. It is maybe still a little too thick, so I'll just make this a little smaller. Let's move these down a little bit. And on the back side, we move them a little up. Yeah, so we're not really concerned that it's cutting into the geometry, as usually we will not really see it when rendering. It's just more a background element. Okay, then we can duplicate this element and then rotate it a little bit, so something like this. And with Shift D, we can just repeat the duplication. Now we have here that it's sticking out a little bit, so that means we actually just need to take all of these and scale them a little bit in, and then we should be fine. Okay, now the next thing we need for the front of the plane is to the propeller. So I'm going to take a cube, move it here to the front, scale it. So I'm just deforming it a little bit that it more looks like a propeller. So something like this. Maybe we take this one and make it a little bigger. And maybe let's just rotate this one a little bit. Now I'm going to just take the pivot point, set it to the center axis, and then duplicate it and just rotate it over to the other side. And as the last step, I'm just going to take both and set and combine them into its own object. And we just name this one here propeller. That we can find it later on. And maybe for animation purposes, it makes more sense to have this as its own object, so we can then just rotate it around if needed. Okay, so now we're just going to clean up a little bit by adding some more edge loops, just to make a couple of these segments a little bit more or less round. So something like this, for example. So if we compare this now to the other side, here it's very very roundish, and here we have a much nicer transition to the wing segment. Then we have to repeat this for the other side, or we would mirror it again or something like that. Then we are going to take here this edge. This edge and scale it a little bit down to make it more flat. So of course this depends on your own model and how you modeled, but I'm just now going through the model and just looking for things that could be improved. So also here the wing shape is not ideal, so add an edge loop here. So that's much nicer. And similarly here in the back of the plane, going to add a couple of edge loops just that the form is a little bit nicer. And depending on how exact you have to be, then you would of course mirror this over again. But for now, it's just to clean up the model, that the details are a little more obvious. Good. So this is all looking quite nice. Maybe still. No, we'll just leave it like this for now. I mean, it's going to be a small plane, and it's anyway just a modeling exercise. So the last thing we're just going to do is we're going to extrude some windows. So we have here a front window. Well, here we can see it better. So I'm just going to select these faces. I'm going to say extrude face. And here we have an offset parameter. And if we set it to a very small value, We can get a small edge, just like here in the image. And then we repeat the extrude and just move it in a little bit. And yeah, so I'm just going to extrude in, move it in a little bit, then I'm going to repeat it again, move it in a little bit more, and that's how we get immediately a nice sharp edge for this window. And then similarly, we just walk through over here. Oh wait, this is a straight line. This we may have to correct still. Okay, so then we just go in here. Select all of the vertex points and scale them in that we have a straight line. And this one also, this one just missed. And then we can just, oh, the face selection is still there. So then we just select this on both sides. And again, we say extrude. A small amount of offset. And if this doesn't work out properly, then you also can insert it here manually. Let's say 1.5, that looks good. And then again, immediately one small extrude just to get the edge, and then we repeat it and move in. And that's how we get this nice edge. Okay, so now we have the side window still, so let's select these here. Now here we have to be careful because here we don't have like an additional edge, so we cannot do both at the same time. So we first do the one side, it's an offset. Oh, I selected one too much, so let's undo everything. Okay. And let's repeat that. An offset of 0.2. Then we move it in a little bit and we move it in a little bit. And we just repeat that on the other side. I just add some. Oops. There we go. Okay, now we could ease this transition a little bit by just repositioning some vertex points. Yeah, and then it reduces this bump that we currently have in the window. But I don't know, I like it a little bit, so I'm just going to leave it now for this one. Okay, and this is now the end of this modeling exercise, and I hope you've learned a lot about extruding objects and using the bevel tool. And yeah, so now we would just clean up the model by deleting the history, maybe naming a couple of objects and grouping these together. So this would be our main body. Then we'd have to see what this is. Oh, this is all our engine cooling. So we just combine these, and then we say engine cooling. And then this all can be deleted. Maybe we shouldn't have deleted that because I forgot to delete the history first. So, engine cooling, delete history. Oh, there we go. This one also can delete history. And yeah, now we also could just add these two objects to the main body. So it's middle click, add it to the main body. And then this is all just one selection, but you still can select the individual components. Okay. And then, of course, save your scene. And then we're done. See you next video.